I am here with one of the locals, legendary Barry Melrose, former NHL player, coach, NHL analyst, NHL...
Everything.
The list goes on and on.
I've done it all. I've sharpened skates, swept out arenas, slept in the rink. I've done everything.
You hear that, kids? You got to start from the bottom and work your way up, and he's done it all. So we're here in St. Petersburg. Tell us a little bit about your impression of Beantown Pub South.
Well, I come down here all the time. My wife and I live in St. Pete Beach. We love the downtown St. Petersburg. We've got 3-4 favorite restaurants that we go here. It's just off Central Ave. My cigar bar is just around the corner where I get cigars.
I went to that last night, yeah.
Central Cigar. So it's a great city. It's a great downtown. It's a fun downtown. And then we just jump on one of the roads out of here and we're back in our house in 15, 20 minutes. So we've really fallen in love with this area.
And you're not going to get out of here without talking about hockey.
Let's go.
Tampa Bay Lightning is on a roll. The Bruins are doing pretty well, too.
Yeah.
What are your impressions of the NHL after the trade deadline?
Tampa Bay didn't even make a deal at the deadline. They feel so comfortable about their team. They're on fire right now. They've lost one game out of 14 or 15. To me, they're the best team in the NHL right now. Either division, it doesn't matter. They got depth. They got great goaltending. They've got three players right now with over 30 goals. No one else in the NHL has that. They've got veteran defensemen back there. Vasilevsky, I think, is the best goaltender in the NHL right now. So Tampa Bay is the place to be. The story of the NHL will not be if Tampa Bay wins the Stanley Cup. The story will be if they lose the Stanley Cup. They are that good. So right now, this is a great hockey area. Buildings full every night, sellout year, day after day after day. And a fantastic brand of hockey, no doubt about it.
Well, let's not forget, you're on a Boston show.
Yes,
so
I am.
Can't rule out our Bruins. They've had a chance against Tampa. They're probably not going to have home ice advantage. But we have proven that we can beat them at home. So what are you thinking come playoffs?
Well, they actually beat Tampa Bay the other night for Tampa Bay's first loss. Boston's a good team. They've got a lot of depth. I love Bergeron. I love Marchand. Their goaltending is as good as anybody in the NHL. But the Boston Bruins, you've got a bunch of the young players. Dabrowski's playing great right now. He was the best player on the ice the other night against Tampa Bay. So I really like the Boston Bruins a lot. They're probably the second best team in the East right now, next to Tampa Bay.
So I think that this is going to be the place to watch the game come playoffs?
This will be one of the... People don't realize what a good hockey area this is. The bars...
I didn't even know Bolts fans existed
until
I was down here.
The bars in Tampa are all full of hockey.
I thought it was an urban legend that they existed.
It is. They love hockey in South Florida. Tampa Bay's fun to watch. The Bruins will be coming to this place. Bruins fans will be coming to watch it here. I would not surprise if they're maybe the two last teams standing in the Eastern Finals, which would be a great hockey round. But, people are watching what's happening in the NHL here. And this bar is the place where the Boston Bruins fans come and enjoy the night. So you can see we got the big screens right back there.
We got them all.
So there's no reason not to be watching hockey here.
So can Tampa be beaten?
Anybody can be beaten. The Boston Bruins are a great example. Those teams in the 70s, Bobby Orr, Phil Esposito, no one thought that they could be beaten. People thought they'd win 6-7 Stanley Cups in a row. They only won 2. So talent's great, but a lot of times will overcome skill. It's when you have both those things, will and skill, then you got something special. And maybe the Boston Bruins have that will and skill.
Now that is a great message for the people of Boston. You heard it here first.
Thank you very much.
Well, thanks, Barry.
My pleasure.